Alrighty guys, it is Qaaman here today, and I'm giving you another spoiler alert for those of you who have not seen Dragon Ball Super episode 125. This video and this episode did not have major spoilers compared to episode 124, but if you do not want to be spoiled about what happens, I suggest you tune off now because I will be talking in depth about this video, and boy oh boy do we have a lot to talk about, as so many things actually went on this episode itself. So let's get this party started. Let's talk about why episode 125 was so brilliant. So guys, the first thing we have to talk about is dealing with the tone. So as we've seen in the previous episodes of Super, Dispo is a more comic relief character. First of all, I mean, he's essentially just a Beerus clone that looks more so like a rabbit. And as we've seen in the fights between both Dispo against Gohan and against Frieza, they used a much more comical tone when he was fighting. We even saw a little bit of this too when he was fighting against Hit. So although Dispo was one of the uber tier characters, we could never really take his character as serious as we did as compared to Jiren and Toppo. And the same thing could even be said for Toppo. Prior to this episode, Toppo was kind of like a gag-like character, you know? We didn't really see Toppo in a very serious light, as he was this overweight Mr. Incredible from the Incredibles Pixar movie looking character that, you know, was always talking about justice, bragging about how he wanted to protect his universe, and we never really saw him in this light. And this episode hits you right in the face by showing you Goku and Vegeta fighting against Jiren in the beginning of the episode and just struggling against him, to show you like, oh god, like these are the final two characters that are way more serious than any of the characters that we've seen before. And when we see Android 17 fighting against Toppo, I immediately started thinking about the fight between Gohan and Cell, where Gohan was firing that Kamehameha against Cell. We see that big beam clash, and similar to the Kamehameha clash, which I'll do a video about talking about all of the references of this episode later, we see that Toppo is struggling against 17 because, similar to what Vegeta did against Cell, Frieza jumps into the fight, starts insulting Toppo, and starts blasting him in a similar fashion to how Vegeta blasted Cell to give Gohan the edge. So when Toppo is, you know, obviously blasted away and we see him, you know, injured and cut up from, you know, the huge attack that Android 17 unleashed on him, the episode completely changes. We no longer see this happy-go-lucky Toppo who was, you know, preaching all of this justice. We see him emerge as this god of destruction and training, as it was revealed by, you know, Makarita in the episode, as she was training him to become a god of destruction, and everything completely changed with the tone of voice. And if you compare this to the previous episode, I feel like Frieza was used in a much better fashion, because as I've said before, I had a problem with the way that they utilized Frieza in the most recent episode, because of the fact that it was so easy to make Frieza knock out Gohan, considering the fact that he's the most ruthless villain in Dragon Ball history. But in this episode, Frieza's personality really came into fruition, as we saw him trash-talking Toppo. He calls him trash. He talked about his justice not belonging in the Tournament of Power. He made fun of his clothes. And essentially, Frieza became that big bully in school, even though in size, Frieza's actually smaller than Toppo. He became the guy that, you know, made you feel like you were worthless. This was the guy who, although he's working towards helping Universe 7 win for his old selfish reasons, Frieza is a good guy to us in this instant, but he's actually being a villain to Toppo. And that was an interesting twist that the episode brought up between both characters. And as you see him continuing his, you know, his trash talk against Toppo, you could just see the look on Toppo's face as he powers up and becomes this god of destruction. And, you know, Toppo's talking about how justice is worthless now, and he has all of these amazing quotes like, he is beyond justice and evil, and survival is what matters. And that's when you just see him starting to wreck Frieza, guys. And guys, I'll be honest with you, I completely lost it. He made one of the most ruthless villains in Dragon Ball history look lower than anything I've ever seen before. And guys, before you point out that Frieza has obviously looked low before, with being cut in half by Trunks, being one-shotted by Gohan in the Fusion Reborn movie, being brought to his knees by Goku and Vegeta in Resurrection of F and in the Namek Saga, Frieza has had his fair share of being wrecked before. But the fashion to which Toppo did it really made you feel the animosity of Frieza just being reduced to like child's play. And I think we really feel this too when we see Toppo shooting his energy of destruction, similar to what was going on in the episodes before, where Frieza and Goku were fighting against all of those assassins. And Frieza also grabs the energy of destruction and compresses it and throws that energy of destruction on Goku. But Frieza underestimated Toppo in this episode. This time it was Frieza with his overconfidence and his ego that got the best of him this time, because although Toppo was probably stronger than Frieza anyways, we see what overconfidence can do when you underestimate your opponent, and Toppo completely got it by surprise. And what I think really added to this episode in terms of the little things that just brought the atmosphere into a much better light would have to be some of the moments that just drew out the episode in a much more realistic fashion. One of the things is dealing with the dark music that was playing when Toppo became this god of destruction and he was fighting against Frieza. I felt like the music was on par with all of the events that were taking place in this episode. And on top of that, when we see Toppo transforming, you can see like the atmosphere changing, and where it has more of like a nebulous space background as opposed to the darker tone that the World of Void had before. So it's like Toppo transforming, or not really transforming, but Toppo's power up had like an effect on the environment. I felt that that was just brilliantly executed in terms of the background and the music. And honestly, guys, it really did feel like the birth of a god, similar to how in episode, I believe it was episode 9, when Goku was powering up into a Super Saiyan god and we saw like that whole transformation sequence going around, or when we see the birth of Zarama when they were using the Super Dragon Ball. So this was definitely a great summoning episode. And if there were some of the things that I would like to add to what made this episode great, guys, it would have to be the boldness of Toppo after he powered up and the reaction of other characters. So we see that after Toppo becomes a god of destruction, that Frieza and Android 17 are just blasting him, and he's literally just walking straight through, you know, all of the energy blaster being fired at him with like no fear. He's not even blocking. His body is so powerful, and the shield that he's emitting with all of his energy is so strong that it doesn't even have an effect on him. And what brought out this episode the most to me, guys, was how realistic the fight felt compared to a lot of other Dragon Ball fights. So obviously Dragon Ball is a fictional series, and obviously what the characters do in this franchise cannot be related to real life. But this fight felt real. It really felt like a bully versus a student being put on. It felt like this guy who had all of these secrets to him that you never knew before. It kind of felt like a mix between a Gohan fight and a Goku Frieza fight and a Vegeta Cell fight. It literally had like all of the makings of a lot of previous things that we've seen in Dragon Ball. And feeling the animosity towards Frieza was one of the best twists that I've ever had. Like, legitimately, you don't really feel anything else like Toppo being this manifestation against evil, but yet also appearing evil at the same time, guys. Like, it was one of the greatest things that I've ever seen. And the one of the best things about all of this, guys, is that when we see all of the quotes that Toppo was bringing back to Frieza, like him calling Frieza a piece of trash, it kind of reminds me of the movie Scarface, where the character Tony Montana took a lot of quotes that people told him before, and then eventually in the movie he uses these quotes against the people who were obviously giving him problems before. So it was kind of like Toppo was bringing back the exact same words that Frieza was giving him before. And if you were to compare this to Jiren, I feel like Toppo has much more character, as we see him being much more cerebral in his words as opposed to Jiren just being this silent assassin. And I think that Toppo having a personality and going beyond his justice made him a much more interesting character than even Jiren is, even if he isn't as strong as Jiren is power to power. So ultimately, guys, I would have to say that this was by far one of the best episodes in Dragon Ball Super, if not the best. I think that the way that you see how this episode went from the bottom all the way to the top and back to the bottom was some of the most brilliant writing I've ever seen. And the way the episode ended with the beam clash between both Toppo and Android 17 was just amazing. It sets up so much hype for the upcoming episode. And to tell you guys the honest truth, watching this episode, I was kind of rooting for Toppo, even though Frieza is technically the good guy in this case. Like, this episode really made you think in terms of whose side should I be on, because both guys are kind of wrong in both ways. And because Goku and Vegeta weren't as involved in this episode, it kind of gave this episode a breath of fresh air and seeing new characters being involved. But overall, guys, I love this episode of Dragon Ball Super, and I'm curious to see what all of your thoughts are on terms of how Toppo, you know, obviously revealed himself as a god of destruction, and seeing how it was executed with both Frieza and Android 17. So with everything else said, please remember to rate, comment, and subscribe. And remember, as I always say, to have a great day, guys. And this episode was the definition of playing cat and mouse.